Germany's Association of Women Entrepreneurs, also called the VDU, has been supporting female bosses and women in the business world for more than 60 years. The group promotes female entrepreneurship and lobbies for better conditions for businesswomen. At the moment, the VDU represents more than 1,800 mainly medium-sized firms that are led by women in areas such as manufacturing, handicrafts, trade, and in the service sector. Together with their companies, these women generate 85 billion euros in sales and employ about 500,000 people. VDU Association members are in Hamburg for their annual get-together. On the agenda, expanding international opportunities and strengthening networks to raise the profile of female-led businesses. And our correspondent Kio Dörrer is at the conference in Hamburg covering it for us. Kio, hi, it's really nice to see you. Now let's start with the topic of the conference and the focus, because of course it's a very complex problem, the gap between male and female entrepreneurs and how it can be closed. I'm sure you've heard many ideas. What is the conference focusing on?
Yes, as you said, the problems are manifold, but what they're actually focusing on right now is supplier diversity. That actually just means getting big buyers to buy at female-owned businesses. So, for example, if you are a hotel chain or a restaurant chain, that means buying more from female-owned wineries or female-owned bakeries. The problem is that women are very underrepresented in this field, and that's why it's important to push and empower and get bigger buyers to buy at smaller women-owned businesses.
And it's a very good idea, as it sounds, to just empower the businesses led by women, but it's probably easier said than done. How widely spread is this concept of supply chain diversity?
Well, it depends where you look at in the world. In the U.S., it's quite widespread, actually. The entire concept is quite far developed. Big multinational companies, big names, are participating in it, and it's also a big deal for their CSR. But in Germany, not so much. Usually here, the big buyers concentrate on the prices and not really the diversity of their suppliers. So that's why they're doing this, and they're putting the spotlight on the topic here in Germany.
Now, let's talk about concrete measures. We know that they want to put the businesses led by women at the forefront, but how? Have you heard any concrete ideas on how to achieve this?
Yes, there is one partner also of the association here, which is called We Connect International, and they're a huge platform, a networking platform, and they basically connect local business owners all around the world, actually, with global multinational companies, big names such as IBM, Apple, Hilton. And so if there is a small business, for example, in Mexico that would like to supply bigger multinationals, they provide that connection. So there's a very concrete platform there, and they have been active all around the world.
Kio Dörrer, thank you very much for the insight from Hamburg on the ideas on how to empower women-led businesses.